biological classification. See here, if you take biological classification, so here in the biological classification, how many types of classifications are there and how the animals are classified? So actually 1.25 million species were identified and described. See, by the process of classification only we can study about the organisms, different types of organisms. Sir, here if you take the history of classification, in the history of classification, so Carolus Linnaeus, he is considered as father of taxonomy. He is considered as father of taxonomy as well as founder of modern systematics. Because Linnaeus was the first scientist who started the classification process. So Linnaeus is considered as father of taxonomy as well as founder of modern systematics. Okay, let's see types of classifications. Sir, here there are different types of classifications are there. Natural classification is there, artificial classification is there. For example, in the artificial classification, generally the organisms were classified based on their external characters. But here, if you take the modern classification, so in the modern classification, there are two types of classifications are there. So in that, one is numerical classification. Numerical is also called as phenetic classification. Next one is phylogenic classification. This is also known as cladistic classification. Sir, here actually artificial classification was believed or proposed by the ancient scientists like Aristotle and other scientists. But that scientist classified the animals based on their external characters. If you see this, that old classification, the organisms which are looking similar, they were kept in a single category, sir. For example, as per that artificial classification, butterfly, bird, bat, these three look similar. So as per their classification, they kept in a single category. But actually, if you see them, they are not at all similar. Butterfly is an insect, bird is an ave individual, and bat is a mammal. So as per that classification, all the three were kept in the single category. So that is why that classification was not accepted. So then natural classification has come into progress. In that modern classification, numerical classification is there, phylogenetic classification is there, or phylogenic classification is there. So in the numerical classification, actually in the numerical classification, some average characters were selected. And the scientist observed these characters in the living organisms. When the organism follows more than average characters, that is grouped into a single category. So that is why it is called as numerical, means number. If you take a 10 characters, if you take some individuals or organisms, if you apply these 10 characters to the 10 individuals, if they follow more than 6 characters or 7 characters, okay, let us group them into a single category. So that was the system of numerical category. And here they only observed phenetic. Phenetic means which are expressed outside. So only external characters and following average characters, considered for the classification in the numerical taxonomy or numerical classification. Next, if you see phylogenetic, actually this is the advanced classification and accepted classification. Generally, phylogenetic classification was based on how common ancestry was shared. For example, if you want to classify an animal or if you want to classify group of organisms, first you have to know about their ancestors. From which ancestors they have evolved. So that we have to observe. So that is why phylogenetic means from which ancestors they have originated. So that is why phylogenetic classification based on the how common ancestry was shared. So that is phylogenetic classification. And also phylogenetic or cladistic classification that measures the genetic distance between the organisms. So this is quite acceptable classification because in this genetical distance is measured. So genetically closed organisms kept in a same group and genetically distant species were kept in different types of groups. So that is why phylogenetic classification, it is based on the common ancestry and it also measures the genetic distance between the two organisms. So here generally phylogenetic classification follows two types of characters. It follows two types of characters. One is analogous characters. Second one is homologous characters. Homologous characters. Let us see what are these two. Analogous characters. Generally, analogous characters are the characters shared by a pair of organisms. Shared by a pair of organisms due to the convergent evolution. Due to the convergent evolution are known as analogous characters. See, analogous characters which are functionally similar, structurally different, sir. So these are functionally similar and structurally different. For example, if you take example, for example, bat, or so let's say another example, wings of sparrow. Wings of sparrow. So wings of sparrow and patagia of squirrel. Patagia of squirrel. So here, if you take wings of sparrow, generally they helps in flying. And patagia, which present in the flying squirrels. Flying squirrels means mammals. Actually, sparrow is a bird, squirrel is a mammal. But here, they both of them are flying. Patagia and wings are functionally similar. Both of them are helping for flying. But whereas, they are structurally different. If you take the structure of wings of sparrow, if you take the structure of patagia of squirrel, they are different in their structure. But they are similar in their function. So analogous characters are the characters shared by a pair of organisms due to the convergent evolution. And these characters are analogous organs are structurally different, functionally similar. So this is about analogous characters. So analogous characters are formed in the individual due to the convergent evolution. So what is convergent evolution? When two different individuals were kept in a single habitat, they adapt for that habitat, they have similar functions. So that is the problem. So this indicates two different organisms, if they are coming to a single habit, so that will develop similar functional organs. So that is convergent evolution. Next one, homologous characters. So here homologous characters are shared by a pair of organisms due to the divergent evolution. Due to the divergent evolution. And homologous characters are shared by a pair of organisms. That characters are formed due to the divergent evolution. And homologous organs are structurally similar. Structurally similar. And these are functionally different, sir. These are functionally different. Okay, see here, if you take example, same thing, wings of sparrow and wings of finch bird. Wings of finch bird. Sir, here homologous characters are formed due to the divergent evolution, and also these characters are formed due to the common ancestry. Common ancestry. So homologous characters are formed due to the divergent evolution or common ancestry. If you take homologous characters, these are formed due to the divergent evolution. And homologous organs, if you see, homologous organs which are structurally similar, functionally different. Let us see one example. So wings of sparrow helps in flying, but whereas wings of finch bird, they helps in swimming. Means function is different. So one type helping in swimming, and here the wings are helping for flying. So function is different. But if you take the anatomical structure of wings of both the birds, like sparrow and finch, they are quite similar. Means homologous characters, structurally similar and functionally different.